sup flappers. So there will be a giveaway running for this video, and I will give you guys instructions to entering it later on. As you all know, this one will be a special giveaway. But before that, I do want to talk about Genshin Impact in 2021. Some of you may be thinking I'm here to trash on the game state, but actually it'd be quite the opposite. While the game has its flaws, there is no denying that the potential is still there. What I do want to talk about in this video is that currently, in this very moment, is likely one of the best times to get into Genshin Impact, and that is no cap, okay? The game has had many additions since its release back on September 28th, 2020. We have had a total of 9 characters added to Genshin Impact, excluding Venti, whom was the very first limited banner. In fact, the game has sort of completed a banner cycle now, with Venti once again being available to summon. So for people who passed up Genshin Impact the first time round and have been thinking about getting into the game, now is a great time to catch yourself when the game is taking a breather. Which brings me to my second point. Currently, Genshin Impact is going through a filler patch where no new content is being released. While old players have found this to be boring, the rewards available for patch 1.4 is certainly worthwhile for newer players to consider embarking on your first Genshin journey. With the current available content, players could easily take up to months to catch up while being part or fully free to play. With the previous mentioned 9 characters, there has also been a new region released, Dragonspine, which you will be going through in the story. Now, I won't sugarcoat it. Genshin Impact is a 100% gacha game. Open world exploration may be a thing, but it's definitely not what the game leans on for content. You will enjoy the overworld earlier on, as everything is new and fresh, but do know that until MiHoYo decides to populate the world with repeatable content, everything will become irrelevant after the first experience. While the world is certainly breathtaking, it is but a shell that carries its contents, the characters. Let me tell you, if you enjoy a good story and well-designed characters, Genshin Impact definitely has you covered in that regard. The game definitely leans towards its story and characters more so than, let's say, combat. While there are sufficient challenges to keep you engaged, combat is definitely a secondary thought to the current game state. While many may be drawn to the open world and elemental combat system, please understand that this game is a single-player game with very limited co-op options. For most, building characters up have kept them engaged with the game but not fulfilled. Meaning, just because you have a powerful roster of characters, you likely won't have enough combat to fully make use of your characters. Hence is why I am issuing this warning for people. Play this game because you enjoy the process of building characters and exploring the world, not because you want to plow through the game and hit big numbers or some sort of end game. Nothing about Genshin Impact is competitive. The game is to be played at your own pace, and endgame is arbitrarily set by MiHoYo. The meta will be ever-changing, so please don't get into the game with the wrong idea. MiHoYo actually makes it a point to stay away from any sort of competition. There is no leaderboard, no PvP, there is nothing that will ever edge you against other players. In fact, the only time where you do get to interact with other players is by choice during certain events where they offer co-op capabilities, or when you are farming for artifacts in artifacts domain, but do understand that it's always left to a choice and never forced upon the players. So for the giveaway, this is what will be happening. There will be 3 prizes to win. Firstly, for the 3rd prize, we have 1 Welkin Moon. For the 2nd prize, we have a Battle Pass. And the 1st prize, we have the Tier 3 Gem Pack. So in total, 3 winners will be drawn 1 week from today during Jazzy's livestream. To enter, you have to do 4 things. Firstly, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Just go down, click subscribe, turn on the bell, all notification, you're done. Step 2 is to subscribe to Jazzy's YouTube channel, as my man Jazzy is the one providing you all with the giveaway. Third is to join my Discord using the link below. Finally, include the word pain in your comment for this video. Jazzy will be using a random YouTube comment picker to poll for the winner, so make sure your comment fulfills that requirement. I will leave Jazzy's channel linked in the description as well as in my pinned comment. And I know it's mostly my dedicated viewer watching these videos during the content drought, so I thank you all for that and I wish you all the best of luck for this giveaway. Now let's get back into the video. Finally, I just want to talk a bit about the current state of Genshin Impact. While the game itself has issues, it does not affect what the game has in potential. In essence, get into the game for the right reason. You don't want to be jumping in hoping for endless fighting and dungeons to explore while never running out of things to do and be having a blast with your friends. Genshin is set up to be a side game. I know many people have gripes with the current game state, but we do have a responsibility to educate newer players of what Genshin Impact is. A lot of players originally came into this game thinking that it is something else. It really is not. The game is a single player gacha game where the focus is to collect characters and with a small dash of adventure thrown in. Jumping in now will give you ample amount of time to build up your account while collecting numerous rewards, which will be setting you up for a likely big patch update in 1.5. And the biggest advice I can give to any people looking to play Genshin Impact, and that is to always prepare ahead of time. Build up your resources, be it Primo Gems or Mora or general resources, because MiHoYo has a tendency to not announce anything until the end, meaning you likely will be scrambling for resources if something comes out that you're really interested in. That's why I keep saying now is a good time to pick up the game. There's nothing really challenging going on, and it's just all small mini games that anyone can really complete for quite the good amount of reward in exchange. And that's it for this video. Thank you all for watching. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe what your thoughts are regarding Genshin Impact, your expectations, and how they measured up to your in-game experience. The game is great. I still love it, but definitely play it in small doses. Thank you all for watching, and I hope you are still enjoying the game. Until tomorrow's video, I urge you all once again to stay safe and peace.